Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we are going to learn how to resolve course common issue in our Spring Boot application. So here I have already created one Spring Boot application and one UI services. And from our UI services I am just calling one REST endpoint that I have created in our Spring Boot application. So this is my UI services, and here I have just created app component.html, and here I have just printing title value. And in our app component.ts file I am just calling this service http localhost 8080 message. This REST endpoint I am calling from UI. So inside ngonit method I am calling this service. And after subscribing the data, I am just assigning this value to title. And title I am showing here on our browser. Okay, let me start my application. So here I have started my application, that is ngserve, and it's running on localhost 4200. Okay, let me start my Spring Boot application also. Okay, let me go here and just our demo application run. So here we can see I have just created one message controller, and inside message controller I have just created one REST endpoint. So this REST endpoint is just returning one message response object, and inside message response object I am just setting the message received from backend API successfully. This response I am returning from our backend API. So now our Spring Boot application also started. Let me go to browser, and here first I will open localhost 8080, that is my backend API that I have created, and our backend application is running fine and we are getting the response message received from backend API successfully. Now let me go to our UI, and here I will just, so here we can see response my first tab to call API in Angular. And if I will go here and check on the console, so here we can see we are getting access to XML HTTP request localhost 800 message from origin has been blocked by course policy. So these are the common issues that we are getting in our Spring Boot application. So what is course origin resource sharing? It is a security feature which is implemented in browser to block any cross origin request. Means if our UI service is running on different domain or different port, and our backend services is running on different domains or subdomain, that time we will get this type of issues. So if we will go to our UI service, so here we can see we are printing title, and inside our app component.ts we have assigned default value, that is my first app to call API in Angular is printing on UI, but this is not getting message from our backend API. So how we can fix this course origin issue? To resolve this course origin issue, we need to go our Spring Boot application and need to write some configuration to fix this issue. Okay, let me go. And here I will just create one config class, new package config, and here we need to declare one configuration class. So here we can see define security configuration, and on this class we can define annotation @ configuration. There are multiple ways that we can use to fix course origin issue in our Spring Boot application. Here if you will go in our message controller class, at class level we can define annotation @ course origin. So like this we can define here @ course origin. @ cross origin annotation, and inside this annotation we can define multiple parameters like which origin we want to allow So here we can define origins, and like these, and we can define other parameters like which methods we want to allow, like get, put, post, delete. Which methods do we want to allow? So like this we can define here. If you want to allow all methods, then we can use star. But we are not going to use this way now, because with this way we just allow this class to resolve course origin issue, but it will not resolve for all classes. So we can define the configuration at global level. So here I will go and will create one class, that is security configuration class, and here I have defined the annotation @configuration. And here in this class we just need to create the bean for course configurer. So here I will just go and define public web MVC configurer, and here we need to create the bean for course configurer. So from this method we will just return the object of web MVC configurer. So here we just need to override the method, that is add course mappings. And here we need to pass course registry. So here we can define it as final. So here we need to assign registry what mappings we want to allow. So here we will do registry dot add mappings, and here we need to define the mappings. And next we can allow headers, which headers we want to allow, and we can also allow methods, what methods we want to allow. All the configuration we can define here. So if I will go here in our application.yml, here I have defined the configuration for this course. Allowed origin is star, and allowed methods, star means it will allow all the methods, get, put, post, delete options, and allowed origins is star means HTTP localhost 4200, where our application is running, it will allow all the origins, and it will allow all the headers that we are passing. And course configuration means it will allow all the URLs that we are calling in our backend API. So here I will go, and here we need to read this configuration here from our application.yml. So I will just read these three configuration from our YML file. So here just press Alt plus Enter. So here I am reading the methods, allowed headers, and course configuration from our application.yml file. So I will just copy, and it will pass in add mappings, and allowed headers we will pass here, and allowed methods we can pass here. So now I will stop my Spring Boot application and start it again, and we'll check if our course origin issue is fixed or it's still existing. So let me restart my application. I have stopped. So run this application, and here we can see in our message controller class, I am just returning this message in our message response class, message received from backend API successfully. So now we will go to our browser and refresh this endpoint. So here we can see there is no course policy issue. We are getting the response from our backend API, message received from backend API successfully. And here we can also see message received from backend API successfully. So this is a global configuration that we can use to fix our course origin issue in our Spring Boot application. So these are three or four lines of code that we need to use. But in our pom.xml, if we are using our Spring security jar and like this, then this way will not work. Then we need to use one another approach. If we are using these dependencies in our Spring security, then this configuration will not work. If we are using Spring security in our project, then we must take one extra step to make sure it plays well with cores. So that's because cores needs to be processed first, otherwise Spring security will reject the request before it reaches to Spring MVC. So we need to mention HTTP security cores method in the security config. So let me create one more class. So that we will not use, I will just creating one class, new class, security config 2. So I will just paste the code here. So here I will just paste it, because we are not using till now Spring security, so these dependencies are imported into our application. So this is the way that we need to use if we are using Spring security in our application. Then we need to declare this, then we need to use this HTTP security methods with cores, http.cores. If we are not using Spring security, then this configuration is enough. Thanks for watching this video.